I think first experience when I really took note would have been Newcastle, DJ called Dot Junior, incredible DJ. Very technical DJ, but the difference I think usually is that a lot of technical DJs might not rock parties that well, but to witness Doc Junior rocking a party was incredible for me. So dancing all night, drinking all night, probably more than I should have. But that kind of euphoric experience, definitely from then on out, I was like, yeah, this is for me.
This morning and wonder, hey, shit, I get fresh and shit, I keep it humble. My closet like Dover Street used to be bumming. Some days I'm still bumming. The difference is now it's by choice.
Terrible experience, atrocious. I think most DJs are. I mean, you have to be bad before you're good, right, at the same time. But first experience, I think it would have been a mixed track controller. One of the very first ones, very old, and multiple train wrecks, car crashes. Bad, but it was a learning experience, so I'm appreciative of it. It was necessary, but Mixtrack Pro, very old laptop, and yeah, it was an experience. It ain't in the vitamin C and they system to get rid of me. I'm a killer, relentless. On top of that, I sound like I'm still in the trenches. I come from the villa, I turn villains to victims. Reaches the RIP, fill up your mentions. A message for niggas that's feeling ambitious. I've always kind of leaned towards hip hop and the basis of hip hop, so DJing, rapping, graffiti, right? The graphic, those have always been the three things. Always been a hip hop head, so DJing is just kind of attached to that, I guess. So in terms of tablism, and especially how turntablism has evolved with genres and generally mashing them together, not strictly hip hop anymore for me. It's a great way to blend genres together and a really nice way that a DJ can show their personality for me without necessarily not just through track selection, but also through a skill set which they can develop.
Baby, if you give it to me, I'll give it to you. I know what you want. You know I got it, baby. If you give it to me, I'll give it to you. As long as you want, you know I got it.
Fundamentals first, always. The most important thing that you need to pick up is fundamentals. I'd say beat matching, but now with the sync button, I mean BPM counters and everything else, it's made that a lot more simple. But stick with the fundamentals first. Practice, practice, practice. Know your songs, set your cue points, prepare your sets. These are the most important things. Everything else is really easy. If you're prepared, you know your music, and you know your fundamentals, you'll be good. Wait, wait, wait. Forgive me, I'm a rider, still I'm the development and technology has been insane across the board. So we've got stuff like phase, so you've got the wireless technology now, so you don't have to worry about styluses, you don't have to worry about dust on the stylus, you don't have to worry about interrupted signals, you don't have to worry about contact points on your turntables, which is great. And now you've got moving controllers. So the way it's helped me really though is, and all DJs I think, is just, it's made everything more accessible, you know, which is great. Like, that's the best possible thing that can happen, because I know some DJs kind of feel that with the sync button and this and that is bad, but in reality you want as many people to get into it as possible, and the cream will always still rise to the top, in my opinion. The difficult thing for me is I always think it can kind of be better. And I think that's the hardest thing, is that, yeah, I've reached a level where I feel like I can kind of drop into flow state where everything's automatic and I can just kind of do it and that feels great. But in terms of pushing technicality and pushing the skill side of things, I think that there's always room for improvement. So it feels good now, and initially when I could just mix tracks together in a sequence and I knew I could get a crowd reaction, it was great. But I still feel like there's always room for improvement, so I'm not quite there yet. Walk talking like a boss, I just lift a hand. 3 million cash, call me Rain Man. Money like a shower, that's my rain dance. And we all in black, like it's gangland. Say the wrong words, you be hangman. Why me stick to your bitch like a spray tan? Mister, what kind of car you in the city, love my name, nigga, I ain't gotta say. She can get a taste. She can get a taste. Fuck what a nigga say. No Clips, No Glory are amazing. A big group of DJs, the founder, DJ Mad Dog, and a couple of other DJs, incredible group of DJs, where basically the entire mentality is that when good people do good things together, or good DJs, I should say, do good things together, then they can make greatness. So it's that kind of a movement. They've got a huge network all over Europe, America, Asia, basically every continent. And basically they cherry pick all the best DJs and they put them together. So it means that if you're traveling, then most likely you'll be able to link up with other DJs that kind of match up with your skill set, your gigs, etc. So I've been lucky enough to work with the DJs, play in some of the clubs where they're residents, and travel with them. So hoping to do a bit more of that this summer.
Smoke 100 sacks, shooting up your block, switch cars, then we double back. You a funny cat, you ain't made 100 racks. You ain't nothing like Nip Hustle, that's a fucking fact. Putting on for my city, got 100 stats. I'm the realest nigga, and it came front on that. A lot of fake niggas hate me cause they wanna rap. If they dumb enough to say it, I'ma fucking snap. Big guns, big guns, I got big guns, ARs, AKs, nigga, pick one. This young nigga on that shit, you should get on. And I promise you get fucked if your bitch come. No Saminka Wood, nigga, show the crib love. Like that nigga Nip, kinda sick, blood. On the east side, niggas bang my shit tough, it's all up. Even to my homeboy that switch up. Where your money at? We gon' smoke 100 sacks. Shooting up your block, switch cars, then we double back. You a funny cat, you ain't made 100 racks.
Generally, the balance for me is kind of, I guess it comes from the roots. The roots of hip-hop is great, and how that's followed through sampling, I think, especially there's been a huge resurgence in samples and how people are reusing old songs, and that's always been prevalent in hip-hop. So just trying to toe a line through that to kind of maintain some of the roots and some of the new stuff. I don't always appreciate all of the new stuff, but I push myself to try and listen to everything and appreciate it for what it is, even if I'm not the biggest fan. So it can be difficult to find a balance, but I think at the same time, the new stuff should always still be pushed because the youth are the future.
Drunk on Chris, mommy on E. Can't keep a little model hands off me. Both in the club, high singing on key. And I wish I never met her at all. It gets better, ordered another round. It's about to go down. It's about to go down. It's about to go down.
A difficult question. For me, like, a DJ and real DJing is someone's ability to play music to people and gain the reaction that they wanted from the people. I think that's the exact definition. So turntablism is great, I love it, but there's some absolutely unbelievable DJs that are not turntablists. And so for me, real DJing is anyone who can play music to people and those people will enjoy it, and the DJ knows exactly where he's going, exactly where he's taking them, exactly how to control them and control the room. That's real DJing for me. How I did it, did it, did it.